Hey guys, Jake from 8.1 Media here. Today we're doing a video on common problems and reliability of GM's 8.1 Vortec V8 gas engine. The 8.1 Vortec was released in 2001 and was produced all the way until 2006 and was used as the gas alternative to the Duramax for the Silverado and Sierra HD trucks. Additionally, it was used in a number of motorhomes, commercial applications, and even some Malibu and Mastercraft boats in a marine version of the engine. While the 8.1 Vortec does get its Vortec name, it is a little bit different than the Vortex that we've talked about on this channel previously. The 8.1 was built off of the 7.4 Vortec, which in turn was built off of GM's 454 big block platform. So both the 7.4 Vortec and the 8.1 Vortec are big block V8s compared to the smaller Vortec engine, such as the 6.0, which ended up replacing the 8.1, which is part of GM's 90 degree small block V8 engine family. So it does have the Vortec nomenclature, but it is slightly different than the smaller V8s that GM used in the early 2000s and mid 2000s as well. The 8.1 Vortec has a cast iron block and a cast iron head, which makes it really heavy, terrible for gas mileage, but fantastic for reliability. The block, the head, the crank, and the internals on these engines are good for over 1,000 wheel horsepower. And so considering the 8.1 Vortec only had 320 to 340 horsepower during its lifespan, this engine was significantly overbuilt and over-engineered for the amount of power that it produces. And the good news is that this results in fantastic reliability. So today we're going to discuss common problems and reliability, because while this engine is extremely reliable, there are a couple common problems that it's noteworthy to mention. The first one is with excessive oil consumption. This isn't necessarily a problem, but it is something to be aware of because it does lead to a couple other problems on the 8.1 Vortec. This engine is known to consume anywhere from 1 quart of oil for every 2,000 to 5,000 miles, depending on the severity of the consumption. And while the oil consumption itself isn't really that big of an issue, it does lead to two other problems with the 8.1 Vortec that we'll go ahead and discuss after this. The major thing with oil consumption is making sure that the engine stays topped up on oil, because if it doesn't, you can run into a bunch of problems with internal components, the timing chain, and things like that that can lead to catastrophic problems. And so understanding oil consumption and that this engine consumes a lot is important in proper maintenance to ensure reliability, because you will have to top it up with oil to make sure it stays at full or optimum oil levels. Problems that this excessive oil consumption causes is lifter tick and spark plug failures. So that takes us into the second problem on our list, which is lifter tick. The excess oil consumption leads to oil deposits building up around the lifters, which causes the lifter ticking noise that you can hear during idle. Typically, lifter tick can be a sign of lifter failure or bent push rods. However, on the 8.1 Vortec, it's really only caused by the oil deposits and the oil consumption, and doesn't necessarily mean that you do have an issue with the lifters themselves or with the push rods. And so it typically is a problem that's not that big of a deal. However, it can be a little bit annoying to hear the lifter tick because it can get pretty loud. However, what we recommend doing is running a couple cans of seafoam or Marvel Mystery oil through the engine, and that should remove some of those carbon deposits and help remove a little bit of the lifter tick. The lifters and the push rods on this engine really don't ever have any problems just because of how overbuilt it is. While the lifter tick might give you a little bit concern that there's other problems going on, it really is something that's not that big of a deal. It's just more so a nuisance to have to deal with. The third problem that goes alongside the excessive oil consumption is spark plug failure. The extra amount of oil that this uses ultimately contaminates or fouls the spark plugs and causes them to go bad a lot more quickly than they do on typical gas engines. On the 8.1 Vortec, you have to change your spark plugs about every 25,000 miles. Now, if you do have more excessive oil consumption, say you're burning a quart every 2,000 miles instead of every 5,000 miles, you might have to change these a lot more frequently. Overall, this really isn't a problem with the engine, in my opinion. It's more so a maintenance item that you need to be aware of, and you need to understand that the spark plugs do go bad pretty frequently and pretty regularly. And so if you start developing issues with misfires or rough idling, checking the spark plugs is usually a pretty good place to start. Moving on to the fourth problem on our list, and one that isn't related to anything oil consumption wise, is with the intake manifold gaskets. Generally, all cars, once they get older, like the 8.1 Vortec is, they run into issues with gaskets and seals and things of that nature. For the 8.1 Vortec, the one that typically goes bad most frequently is the intake manifold gasket. When these gaskets go bad, it causes an air leak or a vacuum leak and could lead to rough idling, sluggish performance, a whistling sound coming from the engine bay, and can also give you some engine codes for running lean or for running rich. Intake manifold gaskets really isn't that big of a problem. The intake manifold's pretty easy to get off on the 8.1 Vortec, and the gaskets are extremely cheap, and so this is a pretty easy repair and inexpensive repair to get done. Going into our fifth common problem, which is probably the most common out of all of them, is the crank position sensor. The crank position sensor on 2001 to 2003 models fails pretty frequently. The design was fixed in 2004, and so 2004 plus doesn't tend to have as many problems with it. However, this still is a frequent sensor that fails. When it fails, you'll have a bunch of rough running issues, and so it'll almost make the engine undrivable. Also, if you have a long crank, no start condition, it's a pretty good bet that it's the crank position sensor. The sensor itself is pretty inexpensive, but it is a little bit more difficult to access, and so a little bit more challenging from a DIY perspective just to get to the sensor to replace it. And then that means, of course, if you're gonna have someone else repair it, it's a little bit more expensive labor-wise. But all in all, it's still a pretty inexpensive problem to take care of if it does arise. So that covers it for our five common problems on the 8.1 Vortec. Just to recap it, the excessive oil consumption isn't really a problem, but it does lead to issues with lifter tick, which also isn't a problem, just more so a nuisance. And it does cause the spark plugs to foul a lot more quickly. And so you have to change those a lot more frequently. And so that's an added cost of ownership, but fortunately spark plugs are inexpensive. Intake manifold gasket leaks, again, are a relatively minor problem since they don't really lead to any potential catastrophic problems. They just lead to a little bit of rough idling. Then lastly, the crank position sensor will result in you probably not being able to drive your vehicle. But at the end of the day, it doesn't cause any serious problems with the engine, and it's not that expensive to fix. And so ultimately, it's a pretty minor problem as well. All five of these problems really are extremely minor because the block, the internals, and all of the major engine components were so well built. There's virtually never any issues with those components so long as the engine is properly maintained. All in all, this engine should be able to make it 300,000 plus miles without having any serious engine problems. Now, at those mileage levels, you're probably going to have to replace a number of things like belts and water pumps, as well as a number of gaskets, and you might develop some oil leaks and things like that. But the major engine components themselves, so long as taken care of, can easily last well beyond 300,000 miles. So from a reliability rating, we give this a well above average rating. That covers it for our video on the 8.1 Vortec. If you appreciated this content, go ahead and give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for future videos.